In this video, we will use the slope function to create stairs and hills. And also we will use tiles and models to create our bridges. First download the zip file and extract inside your models folder, like we did with the tree models. There is no texture inside since the models will use the same image file as for the trees. Create a new map and call it hills and bridges. And also use the outside tile set for this. The snow texture. So now go to database. We will now configure our stairs to fit in 3D space. So our stairs are on the A5 tile set and we want to configure this line here. And so we have to start with A5 first. And then I will make a multiple selection like this, 0 till 7. This will select all this, the whole line of tiles here. So from 0 till 7 on the X position. And it's on the 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5th Y position. Let's add a side texture to these stairs. And I want to use a rock side texture. So this guy here. And this is part of the A4 tile, so we start with A4, like this, and it's on the 0, 1, 2, 3, the 3rd X position, and on the 5th Y position. Also, don't forget to add a slope function with the slope of 1. What I also want to do, I want to change the side textures, since we will use height tiles for the ground, for this guy and this guy. These are the two that we want to use. So these are part of the A2 tile set. The first one is on the 0x and on the 3, on the 3rd Y position. And let's just copy paste this guy here. And then copy paste the whole line here. And just change the position of the new tile configuration. So in our case, this guy. Change the position of the X to 2. Now that is set, let's create our stairs and some, and away maybe, something like that. Let's use this tile here first, like this, the middle one. Place some stairs here. Here, here, and also we want to make a hill, put it here, like this, and let's create something like a way that leads to the stairs, like this maybe. I place the way at this side, because I want these stairs to face to the east. Like that. Yeah, something like that all over the place. This is not a design contest. Just place something that it doesn't look so empty. Okay, now let's test this out. Let's see if this is working. And they work. Okay. The stairs are trying now to find their slope direction by their own, if we don't specify it. But we know already we can specify the direction inside the function, like we did in the roofs tutorial. But this time we will use another method. We will use the shadow pen brush for that. If you want the slopes to face into a certain direction, then you draw a shadow on the side where you want it to face. Let's try that out. So let's select the shadow pen, and we want these stairs to face to the south. So we draw the shadow pen on the side where we want it to face, like this. This will be a hill or something in that direction. So we want to make this part of the stairs to face south and this one to face to the north, like that, for example. This one should face to the east, so we draw the pen like that. And this one should point to the south. Oh no, let's make it point to the north, because we got already the south one here. Let's also change the way real quick, so that looks... Oh, and the shadow pen, of course, it's disappearing. We will write a new one in a second, like this. Okay. And this one should face to the east. So we're covering all directions here. Like that. Let's try that out, if this works. And yeah, it does. Except for the middle ones, we didn't put any shadow pen here. So, this one are facing into the direction that we specified. Now let's add height, and for this, we will use these height tiles. And when you add height, you should add it so that it aligns perfectly to the last slope height. So every slope has a height of 1 in our case. So we start here, not here, but here, to draw the height. Let's do this for all stairs now, like this. And of course also for these ones. And then the next one will be a height of 2. Same here. And the next one will be a height of 3. And you should also align the height so that the stairs are facing correctly. 4. Then something like this, so we have something where we can move on. Like that. Let's test this out and see how this looks like. So, this is our hill. We can move the hill like that, as we want. And all the other stairs are also aligned perfectly and we can move on them if you want. Let me just show you in what kind of problem you may run into if you, for example, accidentally use these stairs. For example, we will use these stairs like that. And we draw our shadow pen on this side. And we want all these stairs to face to the east. And we want to move on top of these stairs. And sadly, it's not working. They're not set now, but you can set it real quick just to demonstrate that has nothing to do with the height, this little problem. And you might know it already, why is that? You cannot move on these stairs. And this is just because the path direction is not set for these stairs. If you want to change that, you go to the passage direction in database. And as you can see, the passage from this side is not set. If you set it like this, we can move on these stairs then. I'm showing you this, maybe you might think this has to do with the function something, or just to show you that it is probably, if you can't walk on these stairs, then it's the passage direction function that is not set correctly. Now we want to combine all these stairs or these heights with bridges. And this is something that we will do in the next video.